Hi, this is Ms. Toy, and I want to welcome you to Inside the Haven. Here at Inside the Haven, we are mentoring minds and changing lives. We're reaching out to the young of our community. We want to have up close and personal conversations with career and business professionals, bringing people to you so you can identify your purpose, whatever that is. And with that, I want to give a shout out. I want to mention our encouragement card. Our encouragement for tonight is get ready. Opportunity is coming. You know, you have to participate in your success. Success will not be just bestowed upon you, young person. You have to be ready for it. Scripture says that time and opportunity happens to everyone. So the opportunity will present itself for you to do what you want to do, for your dream to come true. But you have to be ready. You have to be prepared. And so with that, I have an awesome show prepared for you tonight. We have Miss Erica Dee. She's a video blogger out of Chicago. She ranges from Flint, but she lives in Chicago right now. She's an awesome lady. She interviewed me once on her show, and for that I thank her. So Miss Erica, tell us, okay, what is your full name?
My full name is Erica Harrington, but I do go by Erica Dee for the blog talk.
So is that, so I guess Erica Dee is your handle?
That is my handle. Okay. I'm Erica Danielle Harrington. So I just decided to shorten it up with Erica D. Okay. It was just kind of I'm from the hip hop era, so I like the little short hip hoppy kind of a name. So Erica D.
I love your voice. You have a perfect voice for it to go over the airwaves. You do.
Thank you.
You really do. Okay. Now what brought you to pick this as a career or a profession for you to do this?
Well, to be honest with you, I first started off in front of TV, in front of the camera, and I loved it so much. And I was always afraid to be behind the mic. I don't know, there's something intimidating about a microphone and a huge room and just you in it. And I gravitated to it more because I love media, I love mass communications, and for some reason, it was very, in this digital world that we're in now, it was more accessible for me to set up a blog and talk about things that I felt were important in the community, mm-hmm. and to showcase different people to spark mm-hmm. ideas. It was just an easy way to go.
Let me tell you something. I mentioned this earlier. I find that there's something intimidating, or it can be intimidating about whatever you set out to do, mm-hmm. no matter how many times you set out to do it. You know how to do it like the back of your hand, but there's still that intimidation factor sometimes.
Yes.
But guess what? You have to do it anyway.
Yeah.
You'll never get to where you want to be or do what you want to do or be who God has called you to be unless you step past the fear, step past the intimidation factor and do it anyway. That's good.
Yeah.
So you started out in television.
Yes.
And so how long have you been a video blogger.
I do video. I'm starting up video blogging now as well. But the radio, believe it or not, I started about a year ago.
Mm-hmm.
And it was something that I just wanted to do as a hobby. So I started it off, and all of a sudden this momentum gained. And the community in Chicago, as well as Michigan, they embraced me and they embraced it. And so I got a lot of encouragement. And I thought, you know what? Why not? You know, it's a lot of. I also have where you can call in and talk to the people, and people were very responsive with it. So I said, hey, I actually have 5 different countries that also listen in.
Wow.
And I was very surprised at that. And I was very encouraged with that.
How did you get connected with that?
Well, it's through, I do my platform on Blog Talk Radio, and so...
So you're part of a network.
Well, it's the www, the wide world of internet.
Okay.
So, because it's the internet, people are actually able to just key in. And it was a lot of marketing and advertising that I was doing, mm-hmm. too, through the social media, and people were sharing things that they liked that I had on there, and... just all these different countries like Jamaica, Africa, Canada, of course the United States, Norway, the UK.
Wow.
And I was just stunned. I just check in every week at my stats just to see who the top 5 countries are. So I'm really, and I've had a lot of those people reach mm-hmm. out to me and want to be on the show. So It's just, it's been phenomenal.
So I'm trying to get my mind around this, because I just keep thinking of, you're listening to the radio and you're turning the dial trying to find a station.
Okay.
So is that what, is that how people kind of find you, so to speak, over the internet?
Yes. It okay. is. It is. One, it's just like with a business, one person shares with another person who shares with 10 more people that share with 10 more people. And it just picks up momentum like that.
No, I mean, what am I trying to say here? I understand the momentum, but I'm still not. Okay, I understand how they find you by word of mouth, but how do they... Nobody's heard. Okay, let's say they haven't heard of you. They don't know about Erica Dee, but yet they find you on the internet. Still, how do they? Are they just surf? I mean, are they just surfing the web, or
some people are just surfing the web? Now, I go through Blog Talk Radio, which actually has a way that you can subscribe. And they have a lot of other podcasts as well. So some people may be searching through the venue that way, and then decide to pick a podcast to listen to. It's like iTunes, those podcasts. So
you can put in certain topics, maybe.
Exactly. Exactly. You can Google things, whatever your interest is. Mm-hmm. But usually they find me over the internet. And some people, there are just a lot of people that are into the internet and that surf the internet for different reasons and different things.
Wow, that's phenomenal. And you said you have 5 other countries?
Those are the top countries.
Wow.
Yeah. So I don't even know what the other countries could be, but those are the top 5 that for this week anyhow.
Wow. Look at that. Yeah. Did you ever envision yourself doing something like that and going that far?
Never, ever. It was just something that was fun for me. Mm-hmm. And I actually had a cousin who said, you know, when I moved to Chicago, I was kind of this little Flint girl in this huge city. And it was overwhelming. So I wasn't as outgoing as I was in Flint. Mm-hmm. So I thought, I've got to find a hobby or something, because this is not me just to sit in the house and then go to work and come back. And then, you know, when I came up on the Blog Talk, it just was just that simple. I said, this is just what I need to do.
So do you like to talk?
I do at times like to talk. And I do like to talk with people. And one thing about my show is I like to talk like, have an organic conversation. Mm-hmm. Like you and I are just sitting here, like my friends and I, we would just sit here and talk like this. Mm-hmm. These are the type of conversations I like other people to be involved in, mm-hmm. and that I want to be involved in. And these are the type of conversations that help to shape our community, mm-hmm. that help you, that help me to be better as a person. So I like to talk.
So the reason why I asked you that is because the things that you like to do is a clue to your purpose.
That's true.
And so she likes to talk, and she found an outlet to give you an opportunity to talk about, like you said, things that help people, things that help the community. And ultimately, if you're reaching other countries, these are things that'll help the world too.
Right.
Okay.
Right. And one thing I wanted to say too, for all those parents out there, I was the child who got my mother called or my father called because I talked too much. And I wrote a lot of sentences. I will not talk in class while the teacher mm-hmm. is. I almost can remember them. But yeah, I talked a lot in school too. So, you know, parents don't worry. There's a platform.
That's okay too, because, you know, what you do, it has to be tempered and refined and right. honed and perfected. So that's all that was. You know, to teach you that there was a time and a place.
Right.
Yeah, that's good. That's good. So you said you've been Blog Talk Radio for just a year?
Mm-hmm. Just a year.
And so and then you also said that you started out in television?
Yes. And now I started that when I was much younger, in high school. Mm-hmm. So there was a program that came on called Teen Talk. And so we were involved in that because I went to Flint Northern High School, mm-hmm. and Miss Petey Green brought us aboard. I don't even remember how I got involved with that, but besides her saying, show up here and this is what we're going to do. And then I just liked it. It just was something that I was crazy about. And then I went off to college and studied in mass communications, came back to Flint, and then my family got started, so I put that on the back burner and then just started this again. Now, one thing that I told a friend of mine just the other day was, ever since I was younger, I've always heard I always wanted to be successful.
Right.
So I always heard, do something that you love, something that you would do for free. And I thought, well, what would I do for free? I'm not doing nothing for free. You gotta pay for it, you know. And then when I started this, all of a sudden this passion just came out of me, and I couldn't sleep at 3 o'clock in the morning for thinking about a show or an idea. And I thought to myself, the light went on, you know, 40 something years later, that's your passion. That's where, that's your purpose. Mm-hmm. That's your assignment. And that's what you would do for free.
You know, it's something to be said about submitting to authority, which means just simply doing what you're asked to do. You know, sometimes we don't like our teachers. Sometimes you don't like the principal, counselors. You don't like the adults that you have to encounter during your school day or your work day, what have you. You know, sometimes kids don't even like their parents. You know, but they're all there for purpose to keep you on the straight and narrow, to get you, to help you stay on the path towards your purpose, towards your greatness. All you have to do, though, is listen and be where you're supposed to be. All right. And, you know, and so you doing Miss Green asked you to do that served you well, because look at
right,
you.
Right.
Look at you.
Right.
And we just never know how far this blog talk can take you.
Right.
You never
right,
know.
Right.
You know, but I just pray it takes you as far as you want it to go.
Yeah.
And further than that, further than that. So what training or do you have any type of degree or in this, or any type of training, or have you read any books, or are you just self-taught in to do this?
I am pretty much self-taught. The training that I received was training from Miss Petey Green and showing up and being okay there when she said be there. Mm-hmm. And I do believe that this is something that possibly God blessed me with to be able to do that. I remember we went on a trip in Florida, my family, and we went to the Space Center. And I used to always mimic like the mechanical voices that you hear overhead.
Mm-hmm.
And so I used to make them laugh all the time because, you know, we went to Spaceport USA. And I would mimic the lady. And I'd say, thank you for coming to Spaceport USA. You know, and I would do those type of things because for some reason I was drawn to that. And I was attracted to that. And it was just a natural thing for me to do that.
Wow.
But I am self-taught.
Mm-hmm.
Self-taught, yeah.
Well, that's a good thing. You know, it's funny how as an adult you can look back and see all the steps you took and the providence in it, the sovereignty and the things you were led to do and the things you were shown and the places that you were taken to that mold us and shape us into who we become. So do you now, or did you ever had a mentor or a role model?
Well, as far as the blogging went, when I first got into college at Jackson State, I had a mentor because I wanted to be in the sports. I wanted to be a sportscaster. Mm-hmm. So, oh gosh, I can't think of her name right now, but she's on Good Morning America now. And she
Robin?
Had cancer. Robin.
Okay.
She was the first African American woman in to do sports, and I admired her for that because I wanted to be in front of the camera too, and I loved sports, mainly basketball. But I loved. I went to, like I said, Jackson State. So the HBCU. Yeah, that was the great experience for me. So there were always live games, and it was so much fun. And that's where I wanted to be, or I wanted to be a meteorologist, or I wanted to be in front of the camera because of her. I think that some of the guests that we had, Petey Green was another role model for me in high school, because there's so many things that we could have gotten into, especially at that time when I was in school. But well, going
she was
there,
here.
Right? And so I was there, and we got a chance to speak with Zerona Clayton, and she was over at the CNN. And I forgot what her office was or her position was at the time, but it was really big, and it was pretty inspiring that she knows these people. And I didn't really make a full connection, but I thought, wow, this is kind of cool. Like, this lady came from Atlanta to talk to us, some kids from Flint. And, you know, I was just amazed at that. And then my mother was a big influence for me because, you know, she always told me little things to keep myself busy. And henceforth, that's why I got into the blog talk, to keep myself busy, not to get into anything else. So Those were my role models.
It's so good to be able to stay on the straight and narrow. But, you know, sometimes kids, wind up taking the scenic route, mm-hmm. you know, but those kids, you know, you can get to it. And if that's you, you know, you can get to where you need to be as well. It might take a little longer, but you can still get there.
Because I definitely took a scenic route. I took a long scenic okay. route. But, and some of the things, I have a daughter now and I try to explain to her.
I want you to get it now.
Right.
So you're not getting it at 40 mm-hmm. something, because it makes a big difference. You've mm-hmm. lost a lot of time. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the scenic route isn't all that it's cracked up to be.
It isn't.
You know, so the sooner you get it, the better mm-hmm. that it is for you and the easier it is for you.
Right. So what, before we go any further, now I know that the blog talk is not the main thing that you do.
Okay.
Would you like to share what else you do?
Sure. No, that's no problem.
While I was busy taking the scenic route, I realized that I need a steady job, a mm-hmm. steady income. I have a child. I need to get responsible. I need to stop hanging out with my friends. Mm-hmm. Actually, there's a phrase that I've seen before, but it made a lot of sense. One day I prayed to God to please show me who my true friends were, mm. and they all disappeared.
Wow.
So that was my answer right there, that none of these people were your true friends. Wow. Get to work, take care of your business. You've got a great daughter, and do what you need to do to get yourself where it is you want to be. But so with that being said, I went to pharmacy tech school here in Flint, and I became a pharmacy technician. Now, I started off working with Diplomat Specialty Pharmacy. Okay. And
they're big business now.
Yeah, they're big. And I helped them at the beginning all of right, that big business. Right. So shout out to Phil and all those guys. So once I went there, it was just like graduating. But I asked God for patience. Mm-hmm. And it's important that you realize what you ask for, because you will definitely get mm-hmm. what you ask for. Now, not only did I ask for patience, but after asking for patients, I asked to be in the hospital, because I working in retail, it has its ups and downs mm-hmm. because you learn a lot, you mature a lot, and you realize you learn people. Mm-hmm. So after working at Diplomat, I went on to Walgreens. So, and then from Walgreens, I ended up being able to get into the University of Michigan and work there, which I was so happy then, but I had to realize each step of the way, I asked for patience for one. Mm-hmm. So then that meant I had to deal with a lot of people who were upset
yeah. mm-hmm.
about their medication. I had to learn how to deal with those mm-hmm. people and earn my patience. Then after the University of Michigan, I got into the government and to the VA system. Mm-hmm. And I'm a pharmacy technician for the VA. And it's wonderful because wherever I want to go, wherever there's a VA, I can just pack up, transfer, and go.
And there you go.
So, and that was it.
Now, bringing it back to the vlog, what if there's someone out there that wants to be a vlogger, mm-hmm. a blogger? I'm sorry. What would they do? What should they do? How can they get started?
Well, I would definitely say do your research, because it's not as easy as you have to talk with people. There's a lot of skills that you have to have. So I would definitely say do your research, because you're going out there in front of people, and anytime you have an audience, you want to make sure you have something that your audience, you have a target audience. What do they want to hear? Mm-hmm. What do they want to know about?
Or what is the need? You know, like I chose the majority community, you know, because there was a great need there, I felt. And I would say check out the different, I use Blog Talk Radio. That's just one of many platforms that you could use. So you have to look and see which one is affordable for you mm-hmm. and which one you can work with. And it depends on your technical skills, mm-hmm. you know. And just be curious. I'm nosy. So because I'm nosy, I go and I do some research and find out something about this. You know, I talk with people. What is it that you want to know about? You want to know about hair? Well, let's find out how we can grow hair mm-hmm. in a week. You know, or are all of these things true, that you can take this pill and this happens? Or how is it that we can come together and help children to, and after school programs? What's available out there? What is missing that people need a connect with?
So is there, would they just Google certain things or Are there certain sites they can go to, or can they find information in the library, or?
Well, I would probably think that they would maybe Google. I would even go to somebody that's in that industry. They're more than welcome to inbox me on Facebook and ask me for any information, and I'll be more than happy to help them with that. Because
okay, because you don't have to be there's no age.
No
limit or to become a blogger.
No,
a blogger. I'm sorry.
No.
I keep saying blogger.
Well,
blogger,
you know, it all goes hand in hand, okay. Because it first started with the blogging where mm-hmm. you write, mm-hmm. and then the the radio blogging is just the internet and you're speaking mm-hmm. over. A lot of people nowadays do vlogging, which is on YouTube. A lot of YouTubers, okay. And so it kind of all goes hand in hand. So you're fine with that, but it's just. You just do your research. Like I said, they can call me, ask me, they can just Google. They Google, definitely. So, and maybe even YouTube, because they have a lot of how-to vlog, you know. Yeah, a lot of how-to videos.
Okay, so blogging, it starts with, okay, so blogging is the writing. Because mm-hmm. I need to get it straight in my mind.
Okay,
so blogging is the writing, and vlogging is videos, mm-hmm. and radio blog is the voice.
Right.
All right,
right.
Okay, I'm clear now. I'm clear, okay.
There you
all
go.
Right. All right. So, what do you like? I think we kind of already covered this, but what do you like most about what you do?
Oh, man, I get to talk to so many people.
Okay.
I get so many different opinions, and it's interesting because I like to see things from different perspectives. Like, sometimes I may think one way about a situation, but when I hear somebody else's take on it, I'm able to see it through their eyes, mm-hmm. and maybe I'll change my mind, or maybe I'll just have a better understanding of that situation, mm-hmm. you know?
Wow. And then, real quick, would you like to share anything with our youth out there that may be listening that may want to be a blogger or do a video blog?
Well, I just want to let the kids out there to know, just stay focused, you know, and invest in yourself. It's best that you invest in yourself at an early age. So if there are different programs that are available, please, by all means, take advantage of those. They're here for a reason. You do receive a chance to get into those programs. Just take advantage of everything that's out there. I definitely would. And focus on yourself, you know, mm-hmm. and invest in yourself and love yourself. Nobody's going to love you and take care of you like you. So that's what I would say. And stay encouraged. Please stay encouraged.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Oh, no, I was going to say it's tough out here.
Yeah.
It is definitely tough. And we all have our things that we have to work through. But just know that on the other side of you, all your hard work that you do, there's a pot of gold. There is a pot of gold, and you can reach it. You definitely can reach it.
That is so great. I tell my granddaughter when I take her to school in the mornings, I pray with her and have her, you know, repeat a few things after me. And I tell her that, you know, mommy and daddy love you, Nana, pops love you, and tell her to say I love me. You know,
mm-hmm.
You know, so she can love herself. That's so important because
mm-hmm.
kids nowadays so much. You know, they have people around them that love them, but they get it mixed up some kind of way because maybe things didn't go their way. They don't, you
yeah.
know, and they get it confused. Or, oh, they must not love me. Well, no, yes, they do.
Yeah.
And you love you too.
Mm.
Okay, with that said, well, what's next for you?
Well, I've got a lot of projects that I'm working on, and I'm really excited. I'm working with Team 810, and we're trying to set up bring the Erica Dee Show to the camera. So we're working on that right now, which that's a lot of fun. That's been fun. And I am trial and erroring with the YouTube station, the YouTube channel. So, and with that YouTube channel, what I like to do is give people different ways of traveling on a budget.
Oh, wow.
And checking out and reviewing different B&Bs different products or you know, just different ways to be thrifty as opposed to spending $1 million on, you know, things that really you don't need to spend that much money
right,
on.
Right, right, right. Wow. Well, with that said, I'm really glad you came to be with me today.
Yeah,
we kind of got off to a different start here, but we made our way through.
That's right.
You came
right.
in from Chicago today, right?
Yes, yes.
Wow.
Fresh off the highway.
Fresh off the highway. And well, I wish you safe travels on your way back. I know you're not leaving right away, but safe travels on your way back.
Yeah.
With that said, I want to give a shout out to my grandson Joshua. He got a scholarship from Kappa Alpha Fraternity, and well, he got a $1,000 scholarship, and he got the second $500 from that for his academics and for playing sports. And I want to congratulate him once again for getting that. And kudos to you, Joshua. And we're looking for you to do great things in life. With that said, I want to thank you for joining us for Inside the Haven tonight. It's been a pleasure. You can also pick us up. You can contact me on 810-577-6556. Give me a call and let me know you want to be on Inside the Haven. We're looking for, always looking for great guests. We're also looking for young people. You, young man, young lady, come on and be my guest. We want to showcase your talent. Can you sing? Can you act? Can you box? Are you great in math? Or do you have a science project you want to share with us? We want to have you come on and just talk about it just for a few minutes. And you can also send me an email at insidethehaven@gmail.com. Again, just send me an email. Tell me, Miss Toy, I want to be on your show. Or you can go to my website, insidethehaven.com, and you can we have something different on there every day of the week. You can also post if you have a event for youth, a youth event, you can post it there, send us email, and we'll put it up on the website. We'll have question and answer on Saturdays. We'll have different topics Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday on the website. Again, that's insidethehaven.com. Did I mention everything? I think I did. All right, well, once again, I'm glad you joined us, and we'll look for you and see you soon. Thank you, and good night.